of the main reasons we call this little planet home is because it has this really nice thin layer of air around it, called the atmosphere.
If the Earth was an apple, the atmosphere would be only as thick as its skin. But let's get a closer look.
Way closer. The atmosphere is made of gases, mostly nitrogen and oxygen. But sprinkled into the mix are special gases, called greenhouse gases, like carbon dioxide, water vapor, and methane.
While greenhouse gases make up less than 1% of the atmosphere, they're what keeps the Earth from becoming a frozen wasteland.
Yeah, you see how these guys are small? They have just 2 atoms each. But greenhouse gases, like CO2, are beefier and more complex. As our planet gets warmed by the sun, heat is released from the Earth's surface and tries to escape into space. But the greenhouse gases are like, not so fast, buddy. Instead of letting the heat pass through, they trap it and send some of it back to Earth.
This is called the greenhouse effect. For billions of years, these gases have given Earth a kind of blanket that's kept it nice and warm.
They've made life possible. Thanks, guys.
But for us to continue to live here, that blanket can't get too thick.
Check out our next door neighbor, Venus. It's kind of balmy there. Like 880 degrees Fahrenheit on a good day.
Why? Because 97% of its atmosphere is made of CO2.
We've got this planet that's just right, with its nice light blanket. Oh, wait, what's all this floating in? More CO2, and we know where that's coming from. Burning fossil fuels.
Check this out. Scientists have studied ice core samples going back 800,000 years and found that carbon dioxide and global temperatures go up together, they go down together. It makes sense. The more CO2, the stronger the greenhouse effect, the warmer our planet gets.
For this entire time, CO2 levels have never gone above 300 parts per million, or PPM. That is until now. Where's CO2 today? Whoa, over 400 ppm for the first time in human existence.
Right here is where modern humans appeared on Earth. Right here is when we started burning fossil fuels.
You see how carbon dioxide levels are going through the roof? And they're still climbing. Compared to the last 800,000 years, we're now emitting CO2 100 times faster than ever measured before.
Since CO2 started spiking, our planet has definitely been heating up. That means there's more heat energy to fuel the Earth's climate system. The water cycle goes on overdrive, so weather becomes more extreme.
Climate change isn't a future problem. It's already started. We're breaking records left and right. In 2017, Arizona got so hot that the weather map ran out of colors.
Hurricane Harvey dumped so much rain on Houston that the rain maps had to come up with new colors too.
Dry places get drier, wet places get wetter. Warm oceans expand and melting glaciers make sea levels rise even more.
What does this all mean for the US? Towns built on icy permafrost will just disappear. But even if you don't live in Alaska, maybe you live on a coast where rising sea levels could put your house underwater.
Does your hometown get heat waves? They're getting worse. In the east, we're seeing more destructive storms and hurricanes. Severe droughts and flash floods are ruining farmlands. Wildfires are getting way bigger.
Then there's a spread of diseases, like West Nile virus and Lyme disease. Not to mention, pollen allergies get worse everywhere.
So yeah, it's serious for all of us.
Of course, we're not the only country on Earth. Small island nations are literally disappearing under the sea. 1/5 of Bangladesh is at risk of going underwater, which would force tens of millions of people to become climate refugees.
And while some have too much water, others have too little. Farmers in Africa are suffering from major droughts and are unable to grow food.
This is terrible stuff. It's really scary to think about.
Yeah, and while we're all at risk, many of the poorest people are being hit the hardest. Many live closest to the sources of pollution, and they have the least resources to protect themselves from the dirty air, extreme storms, and droughts.
That's really unfair, especially because they're creating much less CO2 than others.
But you know who else it's unfair to? You. Our generation didn't start this problem. We didn't choose to do nothing about it for decades. But we're the ones who are going to have to deal with it, because we've got our whole lives ahead of us. The younger you are, the less you've contributed to this problem, but the longer you're going to be facing it.
In fact, lots of young people's lives have already been affected by climate change. Let's meet a few of them.